We will not stop praying till you break through with you by your glory. We will not stop till you come alive inside of us. We will not stop praying till you penetrate us with your holy fire. Till you come alive inside of us, even this night. Holy Spirit, we welcome your holy and mighty Lord. We yield to your Holy Spirit. We yield to your worship. We yield to your everlasting love and kindness. Hold on the same night. Yield to your power that forgives us from all our sins. We yield to the everlasting life of Jesus. I surrender myself completely. I surrender my thoughts. I surrender my flesh. I surrender my imaginations. I surrender my heart and mind. I surrender. I surrender everything. I surrender this church into your hands, your people into your hands. I surrender your plans and purposes into your hands. I surrender every thought in my life becoming total submission. you may speak, that you may live, that you may speak as we wait upon you.
Hey. Thank you.
Now I will open the heavens, said the Lord. I will reveal myself to your spirit, and I will come alive within you as you yield to me. This day, as you yield to me, as you wait on me, I will begin to lead you, guide you, and teach you. I will show you what I want you to do. I will teach you how to yield to my everlasting love, of my love. I will give you the words that I want you to speak. I will move by my gifts of my spirit to those who are ready to receive ministry by my anointing. For you cannot do anything without me. But as you learn to wait on me and wait for me to lead and guide and speak, even what I want you to speak and to say, even the ones that I want you to pray, as I show you where the people's hearts are at, as I will show you how to lead them into that fellowship and relationship with me, I will give you the utterance of those words to speak, and those people will hear my voice, and they will respond to my power, and I will cause them to come alive. For you have not chosen me. Remember, I am the one who chose you. I have ordained you in my Son, Jesus Christ. I have ordained you in his life, in the anointing, and not of yourselves. As you understand, when your life ends, then his life begins. And as you live my life that begins to continue to live, I shall do greater works than these that you may marvel. You will know that it's not you, but it's my spirit and it's going to manifest. Therefore, give me the glory and honor for everything what I shall do. And remain humble and boast not in yourselves, or try to exalt yourself as if you have done something great. For when you surrender in this manner with my spirit, I will use you in an amazing way that you never thought was possible. And as you continue to grow and yield to my will and to my ways and to my love and my truth, I will cause my faith to come alive inside of you. And I will then begin to manifest myself through my anointing and through my spirit that is in me. Yield this back to my spirit and lean not unto your understanding. Do not try to figure this out in your heart or mind. Just accept the truth that what I'm saying to you in the Holy Ghost. For the time has come that I shall bring you back where you were. I shall bring you back into that place where you once was walking with me years ago. But this time, as I bring you into that place, to surrender yourself more to me than you ever done in your life. Because now you know that you will allow your flesh to interfere in what I'm doing, or trying to analyze, or trying to take things into your own hands. So you will grow, and you will begin to manifest my word, my words that go forth in such amazing ways. You will see that what I say will come to pass. You shall see what I declare will deliver my children and set them free. And what I say will cause the lame to walk and the blind to see and the deaf to hear. For without me speaking, there's nothing you can do. Only thing you can do is humble, pray and yield, and wait on my spirit, and wait on me to speak and manifest. Even as I train my children, as I teach them how to walk with me, I will give you the words that you need to say, that as they begin to humble themselves to my will and to my word, they will enter into the same place with me that my son Jesus was walking with me. As he is, so you will be also in this world. There is a price that you will have to pay. There's going to be a lot of humbling and yielding to my spirit. There's going to be many things that's going to trial and test you, trying to take you out of my presence, to get you reacting to your natural man, and trying to get you to go into the ways of the carnal thoughts. Even now, I have chosen to put the foundation of the world. What I have ordained to do this hour must be led by my spirit and not led by man's intuition and understanding. You got to understand, I want you to yield yourself to me and to my spirit so I can come alive inside of you. So my spirit can take over your thoughts and your minds. And you cannot do anything until you hear me speak. So don't be anxious to run ahead of me. Don't try to do something what I haven't said. Even when you minister to people, don't try to minister for me. You must wait on me to minister. You must wait on me to speak. You must put your total dependence on what I'm going to do. Even in your situation, do not do anything unless I tell you. Do not try to cause things to take place, but let me cause it to happen. When I tell you what I want you to do, when I speak the direction and guidance, not based on what you know, but based on things you do not see, nor understand or see. Because if it was your ability to see it, and if it was your ability to do it, then you don't really need me, do you? But since I'm in the anointing and the spirit, you must depend on my leadership and guidance. Like I led my son when he was on earth. He didn't do nothing without me. And what I revealed to him, he was able to do because my spirit was the one that was doing it. it was my anointing that was working through him. In a like manner, I also want you to yield to me. And let me anoint you even when you pray, that I will have you to say things in your prayer time that you normally would not say. I will anoint you to speak in such a way you shall see results, which my Holy Spirit is going to accomplish. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Not
And no man may appear to be doing things that may look like they're really accomplishing a lot of things. But I want you to know, it's not the same when I start doing things. No man can get glory for it, because people will know that what I'm doing cannot be done by man. It can only be done by my Spirit. Just like the disciples, they were fishing all night and they didn't catch nothing. They came early in the morning again, and the Lord says, well, did you catch anything? And they said, no, we pulled all night. We have labored and nothing has come. Then Jesus says, well, cast the net on the right side of the boat. They looked at him and said, you're not a fisherman. What do you know about fishing? This is not the hour to be fishing. Nevertheless, we'll do what you tell us to do. And when they obeyed my Spirit, but told them to cast the net on the right side of the boat, is when they caught a multitude of fishes in so much. They had to get on the ships to help them bring in the harvest in. Because the harvest was too big for them to handle. And that's exactly when I begin to move in such a glorious way. You will not be able to handle it yourself. You're going to need each other, and you're going to humble yourselves to one another so God can lead and guide you. Hallelujah. And that's how I'm going to move in these last days. And I'm going to raise you to become dependent on my Spirit and not yourself. As you continue to humble and pray and kneel to me, I will cause you to grow in my Spirit and my anointing, and with the ability that only comes from the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Hallelujah. We want to give God the glory. And I pray that we'll have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. And take time and wait on God. And go over and listen to what you heard tonight. And may God enlighten you. Open your understanding. What God is wanting to do. Hallelujah. By His Spirit in you. Praise God. Thank you, God. God bless.